Hello everyone and welcome to St Mary's Kids Online. My name is Annabelle and it is great to be with you all here today. I hope you have a great start to the summer holidays. Now, as you all know, we are starting a new series, Fruits of the Spirit, and we're going to continue with that today. But before we start with that, we are going to warm up with an awesome game with George. Let's get started.
Hello, Kids Church. So today we are going to be playing the animal game. How it goes is I am going to say a letter and then you're going to have 5 seconds to think of an animal beginning with that letter, okay? So, the first letter is G. Ready? Go! Okay, good job if you got that. Next letter is H. Okay, go! Okay, the next letter is A. Go. All right, so the next letter is the letter R. Go. The next letter is the letter T. Go! Okay, good job if you're getting all of these so far. The next letter is the letter D. Go! Okay, the next letter is a little bit harder. The letter W or W. Go! Okay, the next letter is the letter F. Go! Okay, so the next one is the letter S. All right, go. Okay, and the final letter is the letter E. Ready? Go. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed playing along with that game, and I hope that you managed to get an animal for every single letter. Good job if you did. Give yourself a big pat on the back. All right, see you later.
I hope you enjoyed that game. It's so fun. This week, we have got the amazing Matt Windsor-Richards speaking to us on our next Fruit of the Spirit. Let's go.
So, hello, SMKC. It's Matthew. Oh. Oh, no, hang on. No, I'm not supposed to be wearing the beard, am I?
No.
That was Daniel in the Lion's Den. I know. Maybe I'm supposed to be. Well, howdy. Nope, don't know who I am with that. Oh, I know. I've got to bring in air traffic control. Yes, bring down the aeroplane safely. Hello, hello. No, we're not doing that. Well, I know. Always wear a helmet, whether on a skateboard or on a bicycle or maybe on a scooter. I knew there was three things. Yes. No, what else is it? Oh, I know, we're juggling. Ooh, ooh. Oh, that was terrible. Let's try again. And now it's kind of like a cheap gag, isn't it? Just juggling. Or maybe we're supposed to be doing music. I know. I'll play some drums on my head. What's that? Is that Kirstin? Hello, Special Agent K. Oh, hello? Yes. Hello, Kirstin. Yes, you want me to do a talk? The talk? What, nothing to do with air traffic control or a crazy Australian or maybe a baddie from Daniel and the Lion's Den? Not a talk about... Why am I talking into a drumstick? Oh, no, it's the Special Agent phone. The hotline to Special Agent Kirstin. You mean it's not a talk about road safety? No. Okay. About goodness. Oh, okay. I better put my serious hat on then. We're going to talk about goodness. There you are. There's my serious hat. SMKC, I miss you all very much. I hope you are having a fantastic time. And now I'm going to be serious for once.
Oh, thank you very much. Well, I can only be serious for a short time. Okay.
Okay. But the fruit of the Spirit is goodness and gentleness, love, joy, patience, faithfulness, peace, self-control, and kindness. I want to share something from another verse in the Bible, from Psalm 23, verse 6. It says, "Surely your goodness and love will follow me all of the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." I want to share that verse again at the end. But today is about goodness. And I was thinking about the other fruits of the Spirit, because some of them are easier to understand, like self-control, like being careful. Like, I have to remind Luke and Isaac to be self-control and not get too angry with each other about Fortnite or about what they're playing on the PS4, or just about being kind with kindness with each other. Like Luke, for instance, when he plays basketball with his friends, inviting Isaac along even though he's 2.5 years older, doing things like that. So it's interesting, kindness often comes from the heart, doesn't it? I don't want to talk about kindness though, because others will. There's that t-shirt you can buy, it says "Be kind" on the t-shirt. Just really cool. Kindness is like sensitivity to others. And gentleness is interesting too, isn't it? I think of the toilet paper advert. Soft and strong. But it's true, isn't it? Gentleness. There's something about the soft, something being soft, but also being really strong. You can be gentle. There's a gentleness. There can be strength within gentleness, but being soft. And that's like helping others, I think, bringing peace and calm. But goodness. That's kind of a tricky one, isn't it? Thinking about the difference between goodness and kindness and gentleness. I mean, wow. I mean, I think about being good and goodness, that's a gift from God, isn't it? I think so. It's from deep within. Like how to be good. Jesus is our amazing example. The way he loved us and the way he cared for his disciples and cared for those around, that he healed and that he taught, and he was just amazing. And I think that he, of course, is our example. And this is all about the fruits of the Spirit. So God the Father and God the Son and God the Holy Spirit helps give us these gifts, and we see them, the fruit of them in our lives, like fruits that grow on the tree. Like, the tree looks really good, but is it going to produce any fruit? And we can see this amazing thing in goodness about this gift from God. And I think it's about making the right choice about things and about the right action that can help someone else, that helps others, and that can make them feel wonderful. And I think we can pray that prayer, God, help us to be good. Help us to naturally see opportunities with our brothers, our sisters, our mum, our dad, and whoever we live with, and whatever's going on, about how we can be good. Because we can always see, I think, when goodness comes, and helping others makes us feel really good as well. So I want to share that verse from Psalm as well. Psalm 23, verse 6. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Cool. Okay, SMK, I think I need to
say goodbye. Have a great week, everyone. Thinking of you all. Bye-bye.
Now, we are going to get ready and worship. Let's get started.
This is living now.
Now let's pray. Have your hands out like this and close your eyes. Of course, only if you want to. Do what makes you feel comfortable. Let's pray. Our Father God, thank you so much that you are so good and so kind to us. Thank you, God, that you are always there for us in times of trouble, in times of worry. In any situation, you are there for us, Lord, and we can lean on you and turn to you at any time. Thank you, God, in Jesus' name, amen. Now it's craft time. Now for your craft, what you need to do is you need to make sure you have a piece of paper and you need to draw around your foot. Now, as you can see, I've done it around my big foot. So I've drawn around my foot. And once you've done that, you need to write inside your foot, "Goodness will follow me all the days of my life." So make sure you write that down in bold in your foot. Have fun. I hope you enjoyed that and had lots of fun. Have an amazing week. I can't wait to see you all next Sunday. Bye.